Hello everyone, how are you doing? Welcome back to another quick tutorial. Today we're diving into a tricky issue on your Windows 10 or Windows 11 computer when you get an error message saying a driver cannot be loaded on this device. After installing an update or trying to restart, it's frustrating when your PC won't cooperate. But don't worry, this should be a pretty straightforward process to fix. You're likely dealing with a driver conflict often tied to something like IQVW64E.SYS from Intel. So let's jump right in and get your system back on track step by step. This error usually means a security feature is clashing with the driver. Let's start there. Open the search menu. Down in your taskbar, you will see that little magnifying glass. Next, type in Start button. Click to bring up the search bar, then type Core Isolation. When Core Isolation pops up as the first match, it will be under System Settings. Go ahead and click to open it. In the window that loads, look for Memory Integrity. It's a newer Windows feature designed to stop malicious code from sneaking into high security processes. It's great for safety, but can sometimes block legitimate drivers. You might see a toggle that's on, off, or with a prompt asking you to enable it. It wasn't in the original Windows 10 release. Think of it as a bonus added in later updates, probably around 2018 or so. If it's on, that could be our culprit. Switch it to off, click the toggle, confirm any prompts, and see if that lets the driver load. Close the window, then restart your computer to test it. Click Start button, hit Restart, and let it reboot. It will take a minute or two, give it time to settle. After you're back in, check if the error is gone. This is a quick fix, but it might only be temporary if the driver keeps triggering security. For a more permanent solution, let's dig into Windows Security. Back in the search menu, type Windows Security and open it. Head to Virus and Threat Protection. Scroll down to Protection History. If you see files like IQVW64E.SYS or something else flagged that's being blocked by memory integrity, click it, hit Allow, and save. This watch list tells Windows it's safe. While you're here, scroll further to Firewall and Network Protection. Click Allow an app through Firewall. Then click Change Settings. You will need admin rights, so it might prompt you again. Look through the list. If you spot an app or driver tied to your issue, like something Intel related, check both private and public boxes next to it. Hit OK to save. Then close out. This step unblocks the driver from two angles, memory integrity and firewall. Restart your PC again, start menu, restart, and see if they're both clear now. It's a bit of trial and error, but we're covering the basics. If the error is still popping up, let's try a driver tweak. Open the search menu once more, type Device Manager, and launch it. Once it's open, scroll down to Display Adapters, double-click to expand it. You will see your graphics driver, maybe Intel, Nvidia, or AMD. Right-click, select Update Driver, then choose Browse My Computer for Drivers. On the next screen, pick Let Me Pick from a list of available drivers on my computer. You might see a few options. Go for a manufacturer-specific one, like Intel HD Graphics over a generic Microsoft Basic Display Adapter. Click Next, let it install. It only takes a few seconds, then close out. Restart your PC one more time. Restart and test it again. If the basic adapter was the only choice, that's fine. It's a fallback that bypasses the issue. If it's still stubborn, the driver file itself might be corrupted. You could download a fresh copy from your PC maker site, say Dell, HP, or Intel's driver page. If it mentions that IQVW64E.SYS file, install it manually, then recheck. So that's the full playbook, folks. Toggle memory integrity, whitelist threats, adjust the firewall, and swap drivers if they can't be loaded otherwise. Hopefully your PC restarts smoothly now. No more error messages holding you back. If this helped, like the video, share it with friends, and subscribe for more tech fixes. Catch you in the next tutorial.